What is it?
Should
remember Donald Barbara.
What does he want?
He wants to tell you about Black Jura and about how that, you know,
this better be good. This better be real important, because I am tired. Yes? Yes, quickly, Dominic.
Hiya, Robin. Hi, Howard.
That's Howard you're talking to.
Yeah, you're talking to Howard.
Hi, Robin. Hi, Howard. Hi, Fred. Hi, Jackie. Hi, Billy. Hi, Thompson. Hi, Thompson.
All right, quickly, yes.
We didn't play cards.
He's on a sugar high.
we didn't play cards
because you're a chump.
Don't be mad at me. I was in the middle of
this guy's a real wise guy. I'll take this up on the air with you another time if I was in a rush.
All right. I want to tell you about a study that we did.
All right.
For Geraldo's show with jurors.
Quickly.
The reason they say this is done psychologically, that black jurors are voting not guilty, is that the Afro-American today feels so disenfranchised with the system, without jobs, without money for education,
yeah,
that it's their last place of protest.
Let me tell you something. That's a load of bull.
The protest. You don't protest when people don't get it.
It's the last place.
Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. You're right. You know what? You want to know something? You're absolutely right. It's your way of pissing off the white man. And let me tell you something.
It's not white man, sister.
You know all these Koreans who come over here? You think the white people like the Koreans? You think the white people? What do you think? What do you think? Do you think the Christians liked when the Jews were in a ghetto and that they would put in the newspaper no Jews allowed to work here? Listen, black community has got to go out. Create jobs for itself, create work. You can do that. You start businesses. What do you think? You think these Koreans that come over here, they got a pot to pee in? Come over here, they open up a friggin' grocery store.
I don't think it's the same thing for them, but...
No, of course it's the same thing. You're going to sit and whine about, the white man won't give. Forget the white man already. Pretend the white man isn't here. But he isn't here. He's not had nothing to do with you. Go out and make something of yourself.
The African American.
And you make something of yourself, Dominic.
Yeah, I'm trying.
Dominic, better yet, am I right? You lawyers can go through any amount of money, am I correct?
When you walk in, I can tell you what's in your pocket.
Exactly. Thank you. Dominic Barber, the great Dominic Barber. He is one of the greatest at knowing what's in your pocket.
Don't be mad at me. Come on.
I am not mad. No one could ever be mad at you.
All right, bye-bye.
All right. He's in a new movie, by the way, Natural Born Eaters. You're going to love it. Hey, Dominic tried out for a movie. Do you know about this?
You did tell me, but nobody else knows.
I tried out for the new Al Pacino movie.
Let me tell you what happened.
It's not a setup from you.
Were you in love interest?
I tell you, I'm in two parts. I actually met with...
He was big enough for two parts, they said, when they met him.
You haven't seen me, but I'm looking very good.
Let me tell you what happened. Our agent, yeah, right.
Super agent.
In fact, they want to give him the part. Did you hear about this?
No.
Dominic, do you know they want to give you the part?
No, are you kidding?
I'm not kidding, but they say the movie's not in Cinerama, so they don't know if they can fit you on the screen.
Listen to this. Super agent Don Buchwald.
Super agent Don Buchwald heard there was a call for, they needed a big fatso for a movie. To play, what do you play, an Italian?
I play a lawyer-type real estate developer. It's a new movie called The Mayor.
You don't play it. You didn't get the part yet.
Lawyer-type real estate developer.
So that's right.
He calls me up. He goes, I know you're setting me up. I go, what do you mean? He goes, you got a camera that's going to be there, and I'm going to audition for a part, and you guys are goofing on me. So, I said, listen, Al Pacheesecake. I don't know anything about this. I am busy working on my own film. I have no idea what you're talking about.
Because if you guys have set me up, I'm going to kill myself.
So he went out there and he auditioned, and God only knows if he'll get this part. If he does, it'll be unbearable.
But let me ask you a question. Why did I have to do an audition in a bathing suit?
They should have a love interest for you, a cannoli. All right, I got to go. Dominic Barbara, movie star and lawyer.
Yes.
And frequent Geraldo guest.
Seems like a Geraldo regular,
yeah. Geraldo and me and four people did a study.
A study, yeah, he was in a laboratory.
And we,
you know what they did? Geraldo got in front of the audience and said, how many people here go on juries and to piss off white people? And he stood up.
Stand up. That's what he always does. He counts the body.
Thank you for the study.
A woman who fled naked from a burning house.
Wow!
Told Fort Worth police.
Cool.
She was held as a sex slave for more than 14 hours before freeing herself by using a lighter to burn through the duct tape that bound her.
Cool.
Firefighters saw her dashing nude from the house. Jailed on kidnapping and sexual assault charges are Thaddeus and Karen Moyer.
I would like to represent them. Hey, that must have been a burning bush.
The 44-year-old victim,
naked woman burning bush, get it?
Was abducted from her disabled car in a parking lot. She had to be treated for bites and other injuries.
Turns me on.
Isn't that weird? You know, your car breaks down and two people approach. You think they're coming to help you. And the next thing you know, you're duct taped to a bed.
Gee, thanks for the help.
It's amazing what's going on.
Do it.
Marlon Brando has written a book. A review in USA Today says that Marlon should have tried harder. He doesn't mention any of his wives or his children.
Of course. These guys are all, I don't know, they claim he got a $5 million advance. Who would give him that kind of money? Who even cares about him anymore? Marlon Brando.
I don't know. They do say there are some insights that he delivers about what it was like to work on certain movies, but he's not really forthcoming about who he is as a human being.
Plus, he wrote the book in crayon. My new paperback is chock full of good stuff, written with a pen and paper.
Also, there's a new book on Princess Grace that says she wasn't a very happy camper.
I didn't know she was into camping.
The book is called Grace by Robert Lacey. Says that she had mood swings and her weight gain made her intolerably difficult. At home with her husband.
Does it say what she was better at, camping or driving?
The bloom had come off the rose of that fairy tale princess marriage, and she had to keep young men around.
She is the light of fudge.
To make her still feel young and beautiful. So apparently, Princess Grace was not very happy. At the time of her death. She confided to one friend that when she had this young suitor, she thought he'd hate her lumps and bumps. But she said he didn't seem to mind at all.
Lumps and bumps.
She did have many, many premarital affairs, so she was no virginal princess.
Yeah. We did a study. She wasn't a virgin. She was made with boobs. She couldn't even drive her car. As far as I am, I can drive my car.
That's right.
Her belly hit the steering wheel with her belly. Because I got the Mercedes convertible. Jessica Hankin.
Meryl Streep believes in Shirley MacLaine's psychic ability. She says that... Several years ago, when she was buying a home, McLean predicted the quake that hit Los Angeles. She did that while they were making postcards from the edge.
Ooh, super.
She had just moved to Los Angeles from Connecticut, and even though she said she loved living there, she was worried about earthquakes. McLean said, "How long do you plan to be out here?" She said she didn't know, maybe about 2 years at the most. And McLean told her, "You're in good shape because the big one won't hit until 1994 in the winter."
And a study was performed. It was revealed up.
McLean says the next big one is due in November of 1995.
Actually, the earthquake was caused by me jocking in the neighborhood.
Rachel Hunter, the 24-year-old wife of Rod Stewart,
I'm representing her.
Given birth
to me, darling. I look like a gay birth.
A 7-pound, 14-ounce baby boy.
I just gave birth to a cannoli.
They say after just 45 minutes of labor. His name, Liam McAllister Stewart.
What about Dominic? Dominic Liam Allister Stewart. I would like to represent him in the divorce.
Look at the kind of advice 17 Magazine has been dispensing. This magazine is 50 years old now. In 1946,
This is from a study?
No. They told girls, do point out Johnny's best features. Say something like, you have hands like a doctor, strong and efficient.
Oh, I know what this is. I read this study.
This is not a study. This is what 17 Magazine used to advise girls to do to catch guys.
Yeah, it works.
Don't ever let your irritation show on your face. When you're angry, sit still, be quiet, smile if possible, and start the conversation moving in the right direction by saying, I'm sorry.
And don't light your farts.
That was 1946 for girls. In 1968, they said, don't lose your virginity. Almost all girls who do come to regret it.
Whatever you do, don't lose your virginity. So my wife met me, she complimented me on my hands and then told me I had a stomach like Delaware. She's the woman for me.
In the 80s, they said, do stop looking to guys as your only source of excitement and self-esteem. And don't drink and drive.
What?
And don't drink and drive.
What's the fun of that?
That's right. Jackie,
you're
so happy. You might
hit
a bump and spill your drink.
If you drink and drive, I could represent you.
And the watchword for the 90s, yeah, you consider volunteer work.
You did a study?
No. Just read 17
minutes.
And finally this morning, this is a terrible story out of Phillipsburg.
You want my advice? Bend over.
School officials, Howard, are forming an anti-hazing policy after several varsity cheerleaders reportedly urinated on squad mates.
That's funny.
As an initiation rite earlier this summer. They're continuing to investigate the incident that allegedly occurred in late June while the team was attending a cheerleading camp at the Kutztown University.
What were they taught with?
You're saying girls urinated on guys?
Yes, there was...
or another girl.
There was action taken against several girls, but they were not expelled from school.
I would kill to see that. I really would. I swear, to see cheerleaders going to the bathroom on other cheerleaders in a hazing ritual? I would go absolutely... Is that a turn-on, guys, or what?
Stop it.
Oh, come on. How did they know it wasn't an accident? I mean... Maybe they couldn't aim good.
Oh.
Maybe they were just missing the ball.
Why would they hit another girl when they were in the bathroom?
I don't know. Sometimes I accidentally go on Fred's foot.
Yeah, but men have a different apparatus.
That's true. Maybe you got a point there, Robin. Sexist.
Get to the sexism, Charles.
What? I just can't believe it was girls when, you know, I first heard it. Three cheerleaders have been removed from the team as a result.
Did they eat asparagus beforehand?
The urination was preceded by other forms of hazing, such as spraying...
Spraying?
Spraying shaving cream in the girls' faces.
I can't find it until I pee.
And putting butter in their mouths.
2, 4, 6, 8, where do we urinate?
Clothes were taken away from the initiates while they were showering, so they would have to run naked down the hall
cool.
to retrieve them. And the girls who urinated on the initiates were a senior and a junior.
What's wrong with that if they both consent?
Well, the younger girls aren't consenting. They're being harassed.
Yeah, but it's part of joining the club.
Here we go, urine. Here we go.
And here's exactly what I was about to say. The targets of the hazing were not warned in advance what form the hazing would take. So maybe you agreed to a few hijinks, but you didn't know it would include urination.
Cheryl, she's our man. Use her like a urinal can. I know cool
they
hazing rituals.
They were blindfolded.
The only thing weird about this is that girls are doing it to girls. It used to be college. You know what college guys do? They put you in a room, and like all the college guys... urinate in the room, all right? So when you walk in,
you know
something's going on.
Yeah.
So what they do is they blindfold you and tie you to a chair. I know guys who did this. And while they're sitting there, you take hot dogs and you put it near the guy's mouth. Now the whole room stinks from urine,
yeah.
And there's a hot dog near the guy's mouth, and you rub it in his face and stuff. And he thinks it's no hot dog.
Oh.
And the guy usually vomits.
Yeah.
It's cool.
Well, I've heard the one where they take the guys into the toilet.
Yeah.
And the toilet is kind of stinky.
Right.
And they have a candy bar in the bottom of it.
Right.
And they make the guys reach in blindfolded.
And get it out.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Tell the story when you did the number two on the with the wrestling wrestling coach, Jackie. Just kidding. Of course it didn't happen.
They do have a rumor floating around that... there were pictures taken. But they don't know whether that's a fact or not.
That could be a study.
Yeah, that's a study.
Your Honor, we have a study. The girls were blindfolded, and they didn't know until after it happened what was going to happen to them. Other girls were kept out of the room.
Let me say this. I will pay good money for those photographs.
Oh, dear.
Where was this done?
In Phillipsburg, wherever that is.
Well, Gary, get me a number for Phillipsburg.
Yeah.
Let's call.
It's across from Eastern Pennsylvania, Cutstown. I think, in New Jersey.
Cutstown?
Cutstown University.
Cutstown. So get me a phone number of the school. I'll call and ask if I can negotiate the price of the pictures of the girls. Hello, this is Howard Stern. You said that's what's happening. So
that's what's happening.
All right, let me just run off these commercials. I'll come back. I'll do the plugs when we get back from the commercials. Right. And we'll say our goodbyes.